Hello, and welcome to this edition of School Notes. I'm Michaela Smith. Summer is wrapping up, and yes, it's time to start getting ready to return to school. We have some great news as we head into the new school year. The Virginia Department of Education has released state assessment results indicating students in Hampton City Schools continue to make improvements in academic achievement. The division officials are projecting the highest school accreditation rate in 4 years. Last year, 12 schools earned full accreditation, and this year, 16 schools expect to earn full accreditation. This represents a 33% increase in the number of schools accredited. 6 additional schools are partially accredited. The Virginia Department of Education assigns school accreditation ratings that reflect student achievement on standards of learning tests. The VDOE will release official ratings in September. During summer break, many students found ways to keep busy by participating in summer programs. Students participated in the STREAM program held at Bryan Elementary and Sims Middle. STREAM stands for Science, Technology, Recreation, Engineering, Art, and Mathematics. Students participated in a Shark Tank themed competition by trying to convince judges to pick their made-from-scratch product.
Well, today we're real excited. Today it will be our first Shark Tank presentations. So today everyone will get to see the top three presentations from each grade level from each school.
It's just with all the creativity that you get to do in here. It's fun, and you get to do some of the art, and you get to sometimes make a lot of great projects.
To be effective, you have to be an effective communicator. So it's also an opportunity for them to learn STEAM, mm-hmm. in addition to learn how to effectively communicate and sell whatever they're producing and what they have developed.
Our third compartment is right here. For your clothes, your pants, your socks, and your towels, and your hygiene.
It's a nice program to know that Hampton City Schools offered it, but at the same time, it was no cost to the parents at all. So it was good that they offered this, and it's an educational thing as well, too. So she learned a lot.
An engineering camp was held at Hampton High School to attract young women to the engineering field. During camp, girls had a chance to create basic circuits, program robots, and construct components using reverse engineering techniques.
The first thing we did, because they're going to have to read your directions and put this back together again.
The reason why we're doing this is to try to get the word out and make it aware that, number one, there is engineering down at this part of the building. Myself and two other colleagues teach engineering classes as well as construction, and also to try to raise our numbers, to try to balance out our classes, and to share with the girls the opportunities that are out, that are here at the school, after school, and throughout the careers.
It was really fun. It opened my eyes up a lot. Engineering could be a career path for me.
At first it was something to just like kill time a little, but then when I actually like stood there and enjoyed the moment, it was something that really made me rethink my future career, because yes, I like bioscience. I want to be a biotechnologist. But then this engineering event made me say, maybe I could do something in the engineering field. So it would be interesting.
Basically, they're showing us like what we could do if we were going into engineering and how little things incorporate with engineering, and like how stuff that we would never think actually incorporated with it does. It's kind of interesting.
Some rising sixth graders took advantage of band camp this summer held at Kickatan High School. There, students got a hands-on introduction to the skills they will further develop in class this coming year.
Started, I was kind of scared a little bit because I didn't know how good I was going to play because I never played the drums before. And then I started playing and realized it's pretty easy as long as you practice.
The summer band camp that we have is really important to establish confidence in students coming up to middle school and be involved with new children they're going to be working with. Going from elementary to middle school is very, there's a lot of pressure. So giving them an outlet is a great thing.
Three, I like the sounds that we make and the beats and everything. And it's like, it's complicated, but it's easy once you practice.
I wanted to do band camp because I wanted to see how to play an instrument and how to play music with it and have fun with it.
The biggest thing is having the very basics of understanding music and building confidence, having friendships, and knowing that they are very capable of being successful already before they even start middle school.
The main reason why I'm in band camp is because my brother was in band in Eaton, and then I kind of wanted to do band because it seems cool, so I wanted to try. And sometimes my brother helps me out, sometimes when I practice.
Now it's time to catch up on some of the social media highlights happening around Hampton City Schools. On Facebook, students from Burbank Elementary School had the opportunity to bowl for free thanks to a grant from KidsBowlFree.com and Century Lanes. Fourth grade teachers from Phillips Elementary participated in professional development where they spent their days on the water. On Twitter, new teachers were welcomed to Hampton City Schools during their orientation. There was also a back-to-school picnic event held at Lindsay Middle where students received free school supplies. You can also follow Hampton City Schools on Instagram now at Hampton_City_schools. Thank you for joining us for this summer edition of School Notes. Hampton City Schools has been preparing all summer long for the 2016-2017 school year. We look forward to seeing everyone very soon, and we hope your remaining summer days are great. Now is a good time to make sure you've wrapped up any summer projects that may be due upon your return to school in September. Remember, it's every child, every day, whatever it takes. We'll see you soon.